Hello friends, welcome to our channel Cholo Beriye Ashi. Beauty perishes in life but is immortal in art. In our last vlog we had shared our experience of our visit to the beautiful Shantiniketan. In this vlog we shall share details of our visit to two iconic architectural relic of the British colonial in Kolkata. Prinsep Ghat is one of the finest examples of colonial architecture in Kolkata. It was built in the memory of James Prinsep, an Anglo-Indian researcher and scholar, in the year 1841 along the banks of River Ganga in Kolkata. James Prinsep was a man of science and had studied architecture and chemistry. He became the assay master of the mint in Benares. To clarify more, mint is a primary producer of coins in a country. It is a government undertaking, and the oldest mint, named as the India Government Mint, was first established here in Kolkata. James Prinsep's work was to test the proportion and quality of the metals used in the coins. Apart from his regular duties at the mint, he also did considerable legal work. As an assay master, he also introduced a system of uniform coinage. However, the most important contribution of James Prinsep was to decode the rock edicts of Emperor Ashoka, which was in Pali script. Prinsep Ghat is one of the oldest recreational spots of Kolkata. People visit this place in the evenings on weekends to go boating on the river, stroll along the bank and purchase food from local stalls there. There is no entry fee or fixed timing at Prinsep Ghat. It is open for one and all, whenever you wish to pay a visit to one of the most tranquil spots in the city. Prinsep Ghat also has a railway station named after it. The station is part of the Kolkata Circular Railway. A lot of movies like Parinita, Gunde, Kahani, some Bengali movies like Bomkesh Bakshi, Borun Babur Bondhu, Datta vs. Datta, etc. have been shot at this place. We visited the place on November 1st. Although we have been to Kolkata several times, but we did not get a chance to visit this iconic architecture. There is a beautiful lawn and garden with tall trees and flower beds, making it a perfect retreat for all nature lovers. The pleasant breeze of the Ganga River and the view of the second Howrah Bridge from the place was a treat to our eyes. We had a wonderful time spent out there, and then we headed towards Victoria Memorial, the another iconic architectural relic of the British colony in India. As you move towards Victoria Memorial, you can witness the Eden Garden Stadium, the third largest cricket stadium in the world. You will also enjoy seeing many other old British architectural buildings around this place. Victoria Memorial is a large building made of marble located in central Kolkata. It was built between the year 1906 and 1921 in the memory of Empress Victoria. In January 1901, on the death of Empress Victoria, Lord Curzon proposed the construction of this grand building with a museum and gardens. The building was formally inaugurated and opened for public visits in 1921. Our objective of visiting the Victoria Memorial was to enjoy the horse carriage ride. This is a must try whenever you visit Victoria. It's a 15 to 20 minutes ride and worth spending $500 for the same. We would also advise you to visit this place only in the late afternoon or evening to enjoy the view completely. And of course, don't forget to have fuchkas there. The rustling of leaves, the jingle of the bellmare as the steeds begin to move, and the mild Kolkata winter breeze in your face as you soak in the view of the eternally magnificent Victoria Memorial. That's the beauty of a horse carriage ride we experienced around the Victoria Memorial. That's all from this vlog. We will come back with another exciting experience of a British colony from a beautiful place known as Macliskeganj. Till then, stay safe and stay healthy.